We are doing Vinyasa Power Flow. So these sessions, while it's yoga and it is a lot of stretching and movement to breath, can actually be quite intense. So take it at your own pace, especially while you're getting familiar with some of the shapes. And we're going to work through a beautiful flow that is sure to get the heart racing, the body moving, and to get you feeling the goods, which is what we are all about. Having a vinyasa practice in with all of the other types of fitness that you're doing is a really, really great way to just give your body a little bit of a rest, a little bit of a stretcher, but also enough to give you a good little workout. So when you are ready, please make your way down into an easy seat and just close down the eyes, sitting up nice and tall. Just placing your palms face up on your knees. And just start unwinding, relaxing into the posture, arriving on your mat. Take a nice, big, beautiful breath in. Feel all the way up, right up to the tops of your shoulders, and then exhale out through your mouth. As you do that, just starting to feel a nice little release sensation, a little arrival on the mat. Take a big breath in. And a big breath out. Keep going with that. And as you sit here on your mat, just starting to turn your attention inwards to yourself, starting to see what feels different, maybe a little tight or a little sore, maybe a little open or a little alive. Compared to maybe how you felt last week when you hadn't included all of these practices or habits into your life. And just start feeling a nice little sense of gratitude, maybe bring a little smile to your face for the fact that you have given up so much time this week for yourself to change your lifestyle, your habits, your mindset. And know that this session is no different. It is just as important as all the others. Sit in that moment of gratitude, keep that smile on your face and think to yourself, you can keep going. This program is for you and each session that you tick off is one step forward to where you want to go and to the person you want to be. Let's seal that thought with one round of breath. Inhale and exhale. Slowly, gently blink open your eyes. We're going to roll over our knees into our tabletop. So just bring in those hands directly underneath the shoulders and the knees underneath the hips. We'll go for our first little series of cat-cow. So pressing the tops of the feet firmly into the mat, dip your belly down, big breath in. Open up through those collarbones a little bit and exhale, tuck the tailbone under, lift the belly button to the spine, dome through your upper back. Really press through all four corners of your hands. Find that beautiful stretch and openness in that upper back. Let's reverse that. Inhale, tip the belly down, inhale. Exhale, tuck the chin in, roll the spine upwards towards the sky. Big press underneath the hands. One more round, inhale. And exhale. Let's come all the way back into our neutral spine. So the shoulders are directly over those wrists. The belly button is on, the gaze is in between the hands. From here, let's tuck our little toes and let's lift, hover and hold our knees up. So I want you to think about pressing through your hands, maybe pushing away from the mat just a little. And then feeling that heat burn in the midline, in the core. Stay here for just a few moments. Starting to feel what it's like to switch everything on. Maybe you're doing the session first thing in the morning, so it feels nice to unwind after a night in bed. Let's extend that left foot nice and long and start pressing through the back of your calf. So a little rock forward and back. Just noticing what it feels like to lengthen down through the back of the leg. Bring that left leg back in, extending the right. Nice little stretch backwards and forwards. The heat is building in the shoulders, in the abs. Let's take that left leg to meet the right. You are in a nice high plank position. If you need to, you can drop your knees down towards the mat. just for a moment, or taking a big breath in. Exhale, make your way into your downward facing dog. So press into your hands, lengthen through the backs of the legs as much or as little as you like. It's okay to keep a bend in the back of your legs if that's what feels good for you today. And let's take a nice, really strong foundation, especially for those who might not have been in a downward facing dog before. So lifting all the way up onto the balls of your feet, take a breath in. And exhale, lower those heels down towards the mat. Good, keep that. Can you tip your hips up a little bit more towards the sky? Good, another breath in. And exhale, maybe take your chest a little closer towards those thighs. Good, just noticing how that feels and how active this position can be. This in itself is a full body movement. We are working the shoulders, the core, the legs. One more round of breath, inhale. Big breath out, exhale, make any adjustments that you need, starting to wake up. We're gonna walk the feet towards the top of the mat, bending the knees as much or as little as you like. One step, two step. Good, making your way all the way to the top of your mat. Pull that belly button in, create that space. Interlace opposite elbows with hands. And then just find a nice little gentle sway from side to side. Feeling that big, beautiful stretch down the back. We're gonna meet in stillness. In our forward fold in 3, 2, 1. Come all the way back to center. I want you to think about being really long and heavy through the neck. Maybe taking a little nod of the head, yes or no. Gently unclasp those elbows. Take the hands down to the floor or your shins, wherever they happen to land. Let's take a nice little halfway lift. Inhale here. Exhale, forward fold the hips. Really nice. Now bend the knees. This is called root to rise. So root down through the feet, rise all the way up. Take those hands up and overhead. And then palms meet over your head. Then exhale, let's forward fold right down the center of the body. Sun salutation A here. Let's go for a nice little halfway lift. You've been there before. Exhale, forward fold. Good. Plant the hands down. We're going to make our way back into that high plank position. So step both feet back that high plank. This time around, let's drop the knees down. Untuck those toes and lower yourself all the way down to the mat. Keeping your hands beside your chest. Just take them off the mat. Inhale. Lifting them all the way up. Exhale, lower down. Two more like that. Inhale, squeezing all the way up. Lift the chest. Exhale, lower down. One more. Inhale. And exhale. Let those hands find the mat. Tuck those toes. Press all the way back up into what we call your half plank, okay? So this can be the way that you flow through your vinyasas. Or maybe you decide to lift the knees and make your way back into downward facing dog. Nice work. Let's step that right foot forward. Good. Left foot to me. Take a little halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Let's go through that root to rise. Bend the knees, press through the feet, sweep the arms up, over and around. Hands come together overhead. Exhale, forward fold. Find your halfway lift, big inhale. Exhale, forward fold, plant the hands, step one foot back, then 2 feet back. Now you can drop the knees down if you need to, or if you know where you're going with chaturanga, keep those elbows in close to the body, lower down halfway. Inhale, upward facing or cobra like we did last round. Exhale, downward facing dog. Nice. Step that left foot forward, right foot comes to meet. Take your halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Nice work. Root to rise. Bend those knees, reaching all the way up and around. Our third and final time through this. Exhale, forward fold. Halfway, inhale. Exhale, let it go. Press the hands into the mat. Step one foot, both feet. Your chaturanga or your half plank. Inhale, upward facing or cobra, downward facing dog.
We're going to hold here for one round of breath. Take a big breath in and a big breath out. Good. Let's find our strong foundation here. So just like we started, let's lift all the way up onto the balls of the feet. Lower all the way down, lengthen the backs of the legs. Now they might feel a little tight after the workouts you've done already. So just enjoy this lengthening process. Change your perspective on this doesn't feel great, it hurts, I don't like it, to I'm feeling good, it's stretching, it's doing what it needs to, my body is exactly where it needs to be. Keep that thought in the forefront of your mind. Take a big breath in and maybe lift your hips up towards the sky a little more. Good. Big breath in. Can you take your chest towards your thighs? Press through those hands, active through the shoulders. We're going to lift the left leg up and inhale. Exhale, bring that knee towards the nose, shift your shoulders over the wrists, tuck and dome your upper back, okay? Send that leg all the way to the sky. Good, we're going to do two more. Inhale, bring that knee towards the nose. You got it, dome and tuck. Send that leg all the way to the sky. One more time, bring that knee towards the nose. Again, you dome and tuck, that's to create space. Maybe you rise up onto the ball of that back foot so that you can step that left foot forward. This is your low runner's lunge. We're going to drop the knee down, untuck the toes, and sweep the arms forward into your Anjaneyasana. So this is going to open up through your hip flexor. It should feel pretty nice. Take a big breath in, reach those arms towards the sky, and exhale, half monkey. So we're going to straighten through that front leg. Take your chest down towards your thigh, really nice. Inhale, lengthen through the spine, and exhale, fold a little more. You can keep a bend in this front knee if that's what feels good for you. Walk your hands forward to frame that front foot. We're going to move back into our runner's lunge. So that's tucking the back toe and lifting the leg up. Engage that back leg. Okay, don't let it sag. You want to make sure it's nice and active. Then you're going to lift your tummy off your thigh. Good. Keep that. Sweep those arms forward. High lunge. Good. Reach up. Inhale. Exhale, let's open the arms out, wing them out, and drop that back knee down so that it just kisses the mat. Inhale, come all the way up. You're going to feel some fire build. Exhale, drop it down. Good. Inhale, lift it up. We have two more. Inhale. Exhale, good. One more. Down, open up through that chest, squeeze through the back, come all the way up. Good. Going to change to our warrior two. So you're going to change the direction of that back foot. Make it parallel to the back of the mat and deep bend in that front knee. You're going to extend the arms out nice and long and your gaze is going to come out over those front fingers. Good. Open up through the hips. You want to make sure that your knee is tracking over those toes. Take a big breath in. Exhale, sink a little lower. Open up through those legs. Really nice. Now, just like we did with our high lunge, we're going to take the arms up over here. Inhale, straighten that front leg. Exhale, lower down. Inhale. Exhale, get low. Open up those hips. You have three more. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Good. Just one more. Stretch those arms all the way out. Drive through that front leg. Exhale, hold. Good. Gonna keep that front knee bent. Going to reach forward, flip that front palm, exalt your warrior, reaching it all the way up, big stretch through that side body. Then cartwheel your hands down, frame that front foot, step it back, high or low plank. Lower down your version of a flow, just like we did before. Inhale, upward facing. Downward facing dog is where we meet. Let's do all of that on the right side, but not before we build our strong foundation to build from. Okay, so rise all the way up onto the balls of the feet. Inhale. Exhale, lower down through the backs of the legs. Good. Tip your hips up towards the sky. Find your core, inhale. Exhale, chest to thighs. Right leg lift, inhale. Knee to nose on your exhale. Find that room, find that space. Tuck that knee in. Good. Send it back up. Knee to nose. Send it back up. Knee to nose. Good. Find that space. Lift, press, hold. Step that foot between the hands. Really nice. Anjaneyasana on this side. So that is dropping that back knee down. Untuck those toes. Beautiful. Sweep those hands forward. Reach up tall towards the sky. Press your hips forward. Find that stretch through your hip flexor. It might feel really tight after the work we've done this week. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, half monkey. So straighten that front leg. Send the bum back towards that back heel. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale to fold. Good. Walk those hands forward. Bend that front knee. I'm going to tuck that back toe. Straighten and engage that back leg. You've got it. Square those hips up. Place the weight evenly through front and back foot. I'm going to take those arms forward. You've got your high crescent lunge. We have 5 lunges here. When you're ready, inhale. Exhale, take it down. Wing those arms out. Back knee touches the ground. Good. Send it on up. 2, 3. Maybe you take your gaze to the sky. Find a little back bend. 4. One more. All the way up. Drive up. 5. Send those hips forward. Come all the way up. This time we're going to open up to our warrior 2. So take that back foot to make it parallel. Send the arms forward. Take your gaze over that front hand, okay? Wiggle those fingers so they have your attention. Good. Inhale here. Exhale, sink a little lower. What's happening to that front knee? Have a little check. Is it tracking over those middle toes? Good. Extend the arms long and strong. Take the arms up and overhead. Inhale. Exhale, sink. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Find a nice deep bend. You've got 2 more. 1 more to go. Don't lose that front knee. Exhale and hold. Good. Get strong here. Make this as active as you possibly can. Don't be afraid to find depth. Extend those arms really, really long and strong. Flip that front palm, reach it forward. Exalt your warrior. Cartwheel the hands down, frame that front foot. Step it back, your flow, okay? High to low plank, everything stays strong. Upward facing, inhale. Downward facing dog is where we go. Now we're gonna spice things up a little bit and maybe move a little quicker. So you're gonna take 1 full round of breath, adjust and build that strong foundation in your downward dog. Big breath in, big breath out. Left leg lift, inhale. 3 times knee to nose. 1, send it up, good. 2, 3, bring it through, dome and lift. Step it on through. Drop the knee down, Anjaneyasana. Reaching forward. Big breath in. Exhale, half monkey. Inhale, walk the hands forward. Tuck that back toe. Sweep the arms up. Inhale. Exhale, take it down. Inhale. Exhale, good. 3 more. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. That back quad should switch on. Exhale. You have 1 more. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Take it up. Big reach. Exhale, warrior 2. 1 round of breath. Inhale. Send the arms long. Exhale. Sink it low. Good. Let's take the arms up overhead. Inhale. Exhale. Ready to go. reach up, reach out. Two, find that depth. Don't be afraid to challenge your inner thighs. You have one more. Exhale, take it long, good. Reach forward, inhale, sweep the arm up, reach tall, reach tall. Exhale, cartwheel those hands down. Take your way through your flow. We meet in downward facing dog. Roll over those toes, lift the feet high. One round of grounding breath, inhale. Exhale, press into the hands. Right leg lift, inhale. Knee to the nose. Inhale, send it up. Exhale, bring it forward. One more, inhale, send it up. Exhale, step it forward. Find that space, guys. Lift and step. Good. Drop that back knee down. Sweep the arms forward. Big breath in. Half monkey's where it's at. On your breath out. Good. Stretch through that front leg. Walk those hands forward. Engage that back leg. High lunge. Let's go. Sweep it all the way up. Big breath in. Exhale, back knee down. Inhale. Good. You got this. Four more to go. Find that stretch through that back leg. This is number three. Wing those arms open. Use the breath to get you through. One more. Reach up. Come down. Reaching all the way up. Big breath in. Three, two. Really nice. Get your depth. Find your range. Good. Inhale. Lengthen through the arms. Exhale, lower, calm the breath down, calm your heart rate. Let's go up and overhead five times. Straighten that front leg, inhale. Exhale, long and low. Three more. Two. Low, big bend in that front knee. Open up those hips. One more. Look down that front hand. Let's flip and reach forward. Paint the sky. Reach up tall. Reach up. Open that side body. Cartwheel the hands down. Make your way to your downward facing dog. Your way. You can skip the flow if you need to. Downward facing dog is where we meet. Let's bring that heart rate down just a touch. We're going to make our way into an extended child's pose. So take the knees nice and wide. Send the bum back and down. And reach those arms forward, forward, forward as you pull the bum back, back, back. Take a big breath in. Forehead might reach the mat. Just allowing your heart rate to come down a little bit more naturally. Big breath in through the chest and big breath out, releasing any tension that you're holding onto in your belly. Really, really nice. Nice work. Let's make our way back to our four-point kneel, our little tabletop position. So, just take your hands underneath your shoulders, knees underneath the hips. And just like we started, we're going to see how different our body feels from the first time we did our downward facing dog until now. So let's extend through that right leg, stretching through the back of the calf, noticing if you've got any more mobility or it feels a little bit more agile. Bringing that right leg down, extending the left. Noticing how different that feels. Press your hands into the mat, grip with your little fingertips, take your fingers wide. Extend both feet back and take your hips towards the sky. Find your downward facing dog. Really good work. Inhale, lift the hips.
Exhale, lower the heels. Left leg lift, inhale, just like we did before. Exhale, bring the knee to the nose. Lift the hips, step it on through. And sweep your arms forward to that high lunge. You've been here before, you know it. Really nice, little change here. You're gonna bring your hands to your heart center. That back leg is engaged. You're going to lean forward, reach, reach. One long line from the top of your head to the tip of your toe. And slowly twist so that your elbow and knee meet on the other side if you can. This is a little too much. You can drop that back knee down. But if you can, I challenge you to keep it engaged, long and strong. Inhale, lengthen through the spine. Exhale, twist. Good. Really find pressure between elbow and knee. Find that little twist through the spine. Don't forget your back leg. Good. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, twist. Slowly, slowly take your elbow off your knee. Come forward. Frame that front foot. And just like we did with that half monkey, you're going to straighten through that front leg. Feeling a stretch through the back of the leg. Drop your head forward, chest to thigh. Nice big breath in. Bend that front knee, plant the hands down. You're going to step the foot back to meet the right. Optional flow here, or you can meet us in downward facing dog. Lower all the way down. Inhale, upward facing. Open up those collarbones. Lift the hips. Downward facing dog. Right side. Lift the right leg. Inhale. Exhale, knee to the nose. Find the space. Lift the hips on the ball of that back foot. Step it on through. Get your footing and engage that back leg. Sweep the arms forward. Your high crescent lunge this side. Inhale, breath in. Exhale, sink lower. Take your hands to your chest. Tip your hip, tip forward, tip forward. Take your shoulders over your knee. Really make sure that you're engaging that back leg. If it's soft, you're gonna get a lot of pressure in that front leg. Hold on to this. Lengthen through the spine. One long line, crown of the head, tip of the toe. Exhale, twist over, opposite elbow to knee. Don't be afraid to sink into that front leg, okay? Inhale, lengthen through the spine, think long. Exhale, twist. Good, really using that pressure from elbow to knee. Inhale. Exhale, take the chest towards the sky if you can. Watch the thoughts come and go. Don't mind what they say. One more breath in. Hands to the floor. Straighten through that front leg. Feel that pressure release. Square the hips off. You can bend that front knee as much or as little as you like, trying to get your chest towards your thigh. Bend through the front knee, hands to the mat. Step the foot back, your final flow. Lower down halfway, knees lifted or lowered, whatever's working for you. Upward facing. Downward facing dog. Walk your feet to the top of your mat. Again, bending the knees as much or as little as you like. Feeling the difference from the start of the class to the finish. Take opposite elbows with your hands, just like we did at the beginning, a little rock from side to side. Let your neck hang long and heavy, maybe a little nod from the head, yes or no. Pull that belly button in to create a little bit of space. Exhale, let it go. Gently come back to center. Let your hands find the earth. Bend your knees a lot. And then right down, take your sit bones right down to the ground. Make your way into a little L-shaped seat. Take the arms forward. Pull that belly button in. We're going to roll down really, really slowly. Exhaling. As you make your way all the way down. take your hands just to your belly. We're almost there. And then when you're ready, just take your feet to the floor, knees to the sky. Untuck your back. And then just take one leg towards the sky and then the other. Trying to release as little effort as possible so you can bend those knees if you like. And just start engaging into those really nice deep belly breaths. Letting that heart rate come down. Noticing how your body's moving and feeling. All of your attention is now focused on your breathing. Slowly begin to take one foot down towards the mat and then the other. Taking the feet as wide as the mat and letting the knees knock in just to let that lower back adjust a little bit. Continuing on with your lengthening breaths all the way in through the nose and out through the mouth. Gently, gently as your heart rate comes down, extend one leg long along the mat and then the other, taking up as much real estate as you can and then turning the palms face up. This is now your resting pose, your final posture of the class, and we'll take a few rounds of breath here. Let your feet naturally turn out as you release all tension from the legs, from the hips, your glutes. Exhale out all the tension from the belly. Along with it, any thoughts that no longer serve you. Just letting the chest and belly naturally rise and fall. And allowing the work that you've done to sink in, knowing that you've moved your body in a restorative way, in a way that serves you, that wakes you up, makes you stronger mentally and physically. Fitness is no longer just about being strong in the body, it's about being strong in the mind. When you undertake a class full of yoga postures, you help cease the fluctuations of your mind by moving your body to breath. Know that when a posture becomes very, very intense, that you have the ability to let your mind tell your body that you can do it rather than you can't. Start adopting this philosophy in your everyday life, using the I can mentality rather than I can't. And watch how your day and your perspective change. Take a big breath in and a big breath out. Slowly keeping your eyes closed, make your way back up into your comfortable seat, whatever that may be, sitting cross-legged, legs outstretched. The eyes are closed down, and just like we started, I want you to start stacking that spine nice and tall, being proud of the person you are and the effort that you just gave to move your body. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Bring your hands to heart center, palms to touch. Bow your head in gratitude for yourself, the practice, and those that have come before us and after us. Take one final breath in, and together we say namaste. The light in me sees the light in you. Where there is light, darkness cannot exist. So when you focus on things or have dark thoughts, like negative thoughts, then that's what you're going to attract. But if you have light, positive thoughts, that's the kind of energy that you're going to be, and that's the kind of perspective that you're going to attract. So just making sure today that you carry that thought with you. It's the I can rather than the I can't, using all of the positive language, and just notice how your perspective and your day goes just by simply making that little internal shift. When things get hard in this program, it's really, really easy to avoid the discomfort rather than sit in it. Yoga helps us sit in discomfort. It's not easy finishing a workout. It's easy to stop halfway through. It's not easy to get up earlier to meal prep or move your body. It's easier just to stay in bed or grab something quick, but the result isn't actually what you want. So please make sure that whenever things get uncomfortable, sit in the discomfort, know that it will pass, just like any of those yoga postures or any of the workouts that we do. Shift your perspective. I can rather than I can't. So that's what I want to take with you for the rest of this week. When you're thinking about giving up, when you're thinking about not fueling your body with really healthy food, think I can, because you can. And each of those small little efforts you make will all compound to make the big result that you're really truly searching for.